गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द अनादर मेथड फॉर मिनिमाइजेशन ऑफ बुलियन इक्वेशन. ओके, लाइक वी हैव सीन द मिनिमाइजेशन टेक्निक फॉर बुलियन इक्वेशन यूजिंग के मैप, कर्नोट मैप. नाउ दिस इज द सेकेंड मेथड फॉर द मिनिमाइजेशन, क्वीन मैक्लक्सी मिनिमाइजेशन टेक्निक. सो this is what is the Quinn-Maclucky technique. So digital circuit, as we know, is a collection of logic gates, input signals that derive them and output they produce. Okay, that is what the digital circuit. So these circuit can be expressed in truth table or equation. We already seen that. So both gives behavior of circuit, but how to build is not specified. How to build that circuit is not specified. So while designing our main goal is to what? To design the circuit with efficient circuit. And what do you mean by efficient circuit? Efficient circuit means the with minimum cost. Now minimum cost is what? By using minimum logic gates, minimum input signals, okay, and the specific output that we wanted. That is what the efficient circuit. So again with that, the high speed also and with less power. So one way is to get all these things is what? To minimize the logic function. The first step for getting the efficient circuit is to have the minimized logic function. Okay, so this technique we will see now, Quinn-Maclucky. So this technique is also called as prime implicants method of prime implicants. Why we will see in the technique when we'll see the method. So this the algorithm finds all possible groupings of ones through the search, means we have to search all possible groupings of ones. Then from that complete collection finds a minimal set that covers all min terms. Then because this method searches for all possible solutions and then select the best, it can take a fair amount of computing time. Okay, so it will require the large time, you may say. So it can take minutes to hours also. Similar to K-map, but it is K-map is represented in a tabular format, and this Quinn-Maclucky method is not in a tabular format, but so K-map presentation or the tabulation method, we say that it is similar to K-map, but somewhat difficult and time consuming. Okay. So why this method? So why one should go for this method? Okay, so in K-maps, we have discussed K-map can be used only up to 6 variables. K-map can be represented up to 6 variables. Okay, but this method we can use for many variables. Number of variables, for number of variables the Boolean equation is, we can use this method. And that's why we go for this method. That is the limitation of K-map, it is used only up to the 6 variables. Okay. So these are the three simple steps for this method, Quinn-Maclucky. First is what? Find prime implicants. Second method is draw prime implicant table. Third step is find essential prime implicant from the table. So we will see this by using the equation only, example only. Okay, so this is the example. Here in the function it is given at summation of the these are the mean terms 2 6 8 9 10 11 14 and 15. So in function, how many variable functions are is this? 4 variable, with the variables w, x, y, z. So what we have to do, we have to minimize the final equation. using this Quinn-McCluskey method. Now step 1. What is the step 1? We have to find out the prime implicants. Now what is the prime implicant? So first step is what? Mean terms with binary equivalent and group of mean terms with single one, then two ones, then three ones and four ones. We have to find out that groups. So see, the mean terms are present 2, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 14 and 15 in the function, in the given function. Okay, now if you see 2, if let's take first mean term 2. Okay, in 4 variable, how 2 is represented? 0, 0, 1, 0. Okay, then, so how many 1s are there in this binary 2? How many 1s? 1. The number of 1s are 1 here in this first mean term. Okay, so we have to find out all the mean terms which are having the number of 1s is 1. Okay, and if you see all the mean terms, there is only one mean term which is having the number of 1, 1, that is 8. The binary of 8 is 1, 0, 0, 0. So here also number of 1s are 1. Okay, quantity is 1. That's why here make a group of these mean terms 2 and 8, and we call that group as GA1. Okay, it is only the group name. We can give any group name. Okay, so first is why 1? Because there is GA1 means there are number of 1s 1. That's why the group name is given as GA1. Okay, so if there will be again such mean term exist in the function which is having the number of 1, the 1, then that mean term also will contain in this group. Okay, but in this function only 2 mean terms are there. That's why this GA1 group have 2 mean terms. Okay, now we have to make the second group which is having, which mean terms having the number of 1s are 2. The number of 1s are 2. Okay, so which mean terms are having number of 1s 2? So 6, 9 and 10. So we have to search it. Huh? We have to search it by writing the binaries of all the mean terms which are present in the function. Yes, so 6 means 0, 1, 1, 0. So this having the number of 1s 2. 9 also having the number of 1s 2. Then 10 mean term is also having number of 1s 2. That's why these 3 mean terms are grouped together and we have given the name as GA2. Okay, then the third group, that is which is having the number of 1s 3. Okay, so 11 and 14. So binary for 11 is what? 1011. So it is having 3 number of 1s, 3 number of 1s, and 14 is also having 3 number of 1s. So make it a group, make it a group. Okay, then we have to find out the number of 1s which the mean terms which is having number of 1s 4. Okay, so 15. 15 in this mean term, 4 number of 1s are there. Okay, and there is no such kind of mean term now present in the function. Okay, so this group having only one mean term, GA4 having only one mean term. So we have made these groups, and these groups we called as a prime implicants. That is what our first step, find prime implicants. So we call these groups are the prime implicants. Now second step, so merging of mean terms in group with single change in binary equivalent. Mark that change as dash. So this is the second step. What is this step? So merging of mean terms in a group, in one group. Okay, in one group with single change in binary equivalent. Now, see. So we have to find out the groups or the mean terms which are having only single change in their binary numbers. In their binary numbers. Now, if you see the first. So these two mean terms are grouped together again. 2, 6. This is the first step that we have found out. So see here, this 2. Consider this 2 and consider the binary of 2 is 0, 0, 1, 0. So we have to group together with the remaining groups. With the remaining groups, this mean term with, we have to compare actually with the remaining groups. So 2 is compared with the 6. Okay, this is my first group, this is the second group, this is third group, and this is fourth group. So I am comparing the mean term from first group to the mean term of second group. Okay, so 2, 6. Consider the binary equivalent for 2. So 0, 0, 1, 0. And consider the binary equivalent for 6. It is 0, 1, 1, 0. So if you see here, 0 is same. Here also 0 is same. Then see the third bit. 1 is same. Third bit is also same. The fourth bit is also same. Okay, but only one change, 0 and 1 in this binary equivalent. Okay, so that we have to find out ki only one change is there and all remaining three bits are same. So that mean terms can be grouped together in one group. That's why we have seen here, see, these 2, 6 mean terms are now grouped together, and only what you have to write there, the binary equivalent, the same binary equivalent, but the bit which is different, keep there, mark that bit as dash, and all bits are as it is. So 0 1 0, but this bit was differ in these two mean terms 2 and 6, so that is marked as dash. Okay, similarly, same now. So this 2 is compared with 6. You can compare with next 9 also, 10 also. But there is no such kind of condition exist in 9 and 10. Okay, see. Yeah, 10. 10 is there. 10 is there. So 2 compare with 10. If we compare 2 and 10, see. Now I am comparing 2 and 10. See. So what is the binary? 2 0 0 1 0, 10 1 0 1 0. So these three bits are same. These three bits are same. Only this bit is different. So I can group this 2 and 10 again in one group. So 2 and 10 is returned. Similarly, as first bit is different, so mark is as dash, and remaining bits are same as it was. Now 2 is, you can compare this 2 with 9 also, but there are more changes in 2 and 9. Okay, there is not a single change, that's why that cannot be grouped together. Okay, then now next is what? Now consider next mean term, that is 8 from the first group. 2 is finished. Now consider 8. Now you can compare this 8 with 6, 8 with 9, and 8 with 10. In which only single change is there, you can keep that in one group. So 8, 9 and 8, 10 is there. So you can compare 8, 9. So see here, 8 and 9. The binary equivalent of 8 is 1 0 0 0, and 9 is 1 0 0 1. So you may compare, these three bits are same, these bits are different. So we can write here 8 and 9 in one row and mark that different bit only as dash. Likewise for 8 10. Okay, so here for these two groups, GA1 and GA2, we have made one group, that is GB1. B is for, now this is the second step. So that's why we have taken the group name as GB1. Okay. Now, yes. Now take the mean term from the second group. Take the mean term from second group. Now this second group you can compare with the third one. So 6 is can be compared with 11. 6 can be compared with 14. So if you see 6 and 11, they are not match with 3 bits. Okay, but 6, 14 are match with 3 bits. So consider the binary equivalent 0, 1, 1, 0 and 14. 1, 1, 1, 0. So these 3 bits are same. Only this bit is different. So mark as in a one row 6, 14. Mark that as dash, that bit which is different, and remaining bits are same as it is. Okay, then next mean term is 9. So compare again 9 with 11, 9 with 14. So 9 and 11 match with 3 bits. So here 101, and this bit is different. Okay, now for 10. So 10 with 11, 10 with 14. So 10 with 11 and 10 with 14 both are exist with one single difference bit. Okay, so write both the rows as 10, 11 and 10, 14. Okay, now so this we have made for comparing this GA2 and GA3, we have made one separate group, that is GB2, and that GB2 group contain these many number of rows. Okay, similarly consider now the third group in the first step, that is 11. Okay, so you have to compare this 11 with 14. So 11 and 14 are goes, means they are different in one combination only, so we can write it. Okay, and then only one min term is there in the last group, so compare this 14 and 15. So that also same, the 3 bits are same here and the last bit is different, so write that also 14 and 15. So this is my second step. So I minimize these groups GA1, four groups to three groups in the next step. Okay, now the third step is what? Same as step 2, merging in 4. Similarly, we have to now keep this going, merging two groups in one group now, making two mean terms with four mean terms. So we have to compare this. Now this mean terms become as what? 2, 6. So we have to compare this first mean term of first group with the first mean term of second group. Similarly with 0 dash dash 1 1 1 0 0. So we have to compare this. So here likewise, which mean terms can be combined? 2, 6, 10, 14. Means 2, 6 and 10, 14 are similar in 3 bits. So we can compare here. See, 2, 6 and 11, 14. So here what is different? This bit is different, but otherwise all 3 bits are same. Only for this combination in these two groups. Okay, so keep this 2, 6, 10, 11 in the next group. 2, 6, 10, 11. Okay. Again, 2, you can compare. You have to actually compare with 2, 6 with the first min term, 2, 6 with 9, 11, 2, 6 with 10, 11, 2, 6 with 10, 14. Similarly, second min term with all. Again, third min term with all. Again, fourth min term with all in the second group. Okay. So likewise, if I see here, again the min term is become 2, 10, 6, 14. 2, 10, see. So this second min term and first min, second min term of first group and 210 and 614 is again match. So this is same, this is different, this is same, this is same. So this bit is get different, so I can write in the next group. Okay, so likewise you have to make the grouping in the next group also with four main terms and by making two groups in a one group. So GB1 and GB2 is reduced to now the GB1 only. Similarly, the second main term you have to compare, second group main terms you have to compare with the third group main term. So we got this one, the second group. Okay, so see, now four main terms are there now as we have the four variables. Okay, now what is the last step? Remove repeated rows. Remove repeated rows means what? See, here if you see the first two rows, 2, 6, 10, 14, 2, 6, 10, 14, the main terms are same, and at right hand side also the same values are there for the binary. So we remove one and we keep the remaining. So only one main term we have to keep the if duplicates are exist. So similarly, these also same. So keep only one main term in the next step. These two main terms are also same. So keep one only. So this is that last, remove the repeated rows. Now, so there is no further reduction now. If you see the last table, step number 4 table, there is no further reduction as all the main terms are now different. Okay. So this is the final prime implicant table. Now if you see here the first row, which mean terms are exist? 2, 6, 10, 11. And for those mean terms, which variables are there? Active variables y and z. Y is 1, z is 0, and w and x are not used there. Okay, so in prime implicant table, that what I have to write. Okay, so y z bar, as y is 1 and z is 0, means y z bar is the equation, final equation for which mean terms? 2, 6, 10 and 11. So for 2, 6, 10 and it should be 14, sorry, 10 and 14. So 10 and 14, y z bar is the equation. So mark it as 1, 1 for those mean terms. Okay, similarly, if you see the second row, W is high, X is low. So it is W X bar for which mean terms? 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, so here it is written as W X bar for 8, 9, 10, 11. Those are active. Third row, see the third row. It is W is high, Y is also high. So it is W Y for which mean terms? 10, 11, 14. 15, 10, 11, 14, 15. Okay, so WY for 10, 11, 14, 15. Okay, so this is the prime implicant table. Final prime implicant table. Then step number 6, check mean terms are prime implicants or not. Okay, so prime implicants who covers mean terms are essential prime implicants. So we'll see first what is the essential prime implicants. Okay, consider this is the example. We have to find out the prime implicants which are essential prime implicants. So essential prime implicants are those subgroups which cover at least one main term that can't be covered by any other prime implicant. Okay, so this, if you are considering this first row, so 2, 6, 10, 14 are the prime implicant. Okay, 2, 6, 10, 11 are the prime implicant. Now consider this example so it will be more clear. So number of implicants, that is number of groups, actually number of groups are here. How many groups are there? 6 groups. So consider this K map. Consider this K map. So this is my first group, this is the second group, then this is the third, this is the fourth, this can be fifth, and this can be sixth. So number of groups are what? 6. So there are 6 prime implicant. 6 prime, here it is written as 7, but it is wrong. It is 6, not 7. Okay, so now we have to find out the essential prime implicant. Okay, we have to find out the essential prime implicant. So what is essential prime implicant? See, now essential prime implicants are those. Now here it is 1 and 4. Here it is 1 and 4. Why? Because those are covered with the other groups also. Those are covered with other groups also. So you have to consider the decimal numbers in the K map. Huh? Decimal numbers in a K map. So essential prime implicants are 1 and 4. So here there are two mean terms which are not covered by the prime implicants. So the prime implicants are those which are not covered by the other groups, other prime implicants. Okay, so if you see here, this one, actually I remove this all so that it will be more clear. This one, 4, is the essential prime implicant here. If you see the second example, this and this is the essential prime implicant, because the other prime implicants are covered by both the groups. Other prime implicants are covered by both the groups. So here it is this and these are the prime implicants, whichever it is. Now it is in the K map, it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So here this 0 and 7 are the essential prime implicant. So similarly, we have to find out the essential prime implicants in all these three groups in our McCluskey method. So Y Z bar covers 2 and 6, W X bar covers 8 and 9, then W Y covers this 15 only. Rest of the implicants are not essential because that are covered with other groups also. If you see this prime implicant is covered in this also, this is covered in this also, this is covered in this also. So these are not the essential prime implicant, right? Again, so these two. So this one is not essential prime implicant because that is covered in other group also. Okay, this is not prime essential prime implicant because this is covered in other group also. Okay, this 14, same, these are not the essential prime implicant because that are covered in other groups. But remaining, if you see, this 2 and 6 are not covered in any of the group. 8 and 9 are not covered in any of the group. 15 are not covered in any of the group, like YZ bar, WX bar and WY. So 2, 6, 8, 9 and 15 are the essential prime implicants here in this equation. So these all three equation, Boolean equations, YZ bar, WX bar and WY are the essential prime implicants. And these are the equations finally. YZ bar plus WX bar plus WY. So this is the simplified equation for the function given, which is the function given, which are having the mean terms like 2, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 14 and 15. So we have minimized it to this YZ bar plus WX bar plus WY. थैंक यू. सो दिस इज द मैक्स.